Usually when two people are together, for a long time things seem to change. It's been said that nothing good lasts forever, but this love.
Well, we met, I met him while he was at work. He was working at McDonald's. And after going there a couple of times, we finally exchanged numbers. And from there,
I asked him for a number, and we ended up calling each other for about a week or two. And I told him, you know what I'm saying, I want to come meet you. And I told him I want to come see her. And I finally went over there, and we talked, and I said, well, let's go to the movies and go out to eat. And that's what we did. We had a great time. The chemistry was just, she was cool to talk to, you know what I'm saying? And we just hit it off. And from there, you know, it was acceptable. I would go over there, we would talk and hang out, and it just one thing led to another.
It's like we became best friends, because we just thought we had that undeniable conversation. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when you just felt comfortable just telling him, I felt comfortable telling him, like, things that I wouldn't even tell him of. My
supposed to be
best friend or anything like that, so.
Yeah.
McDonald's is where
it was. When I first met Sarah, when I first saw her, she was coming through the drive-thru. And she just had this beautiful smile, man. And I said, man, you can't do that like 3 times already. I said, man, I got to get your number. I said, you're so beautiful. And the window was cracked halfway, so I couldn't even really just see in the car. She had 10 windows on the car, you know what I'm saying? So, but that smile just grabbed me. I'm like, man, you didn't come through here too many times. I want to get to know you.
It was his politeness that got me. just the way he addressed me, it wasn't on no disrespect. It was more like, hey, pretty lady. You know, when he said pretty late, I was like, oh, Lord. I'm from the country. I done been through some things. This man said pretty late at my worst time ever. So we didn't really I seen him in his uniform, but it was like, dang, you know, he working. If he gonna work the measure out of McDonald's, then that's an humble man.
Yeah, well, you know, I was going through something fresh out of jail. So that was one of the, I had to work. I couldn't be broke, so, you know, I worked that job real hard, and she was like, man, you know what, you go to that job every day, you ain't gonna miss a day. And she was like, I know this place, and ended up hooking me up with this place, this temp, and then I'm getting me a good job, man, you know, making $18 an hour, you know what I'm saying? So if it weren't for her, I wouldn't even know about the place. She ended up looking out for me on that, and it was just, man, when I met her, everything was just going good. Everything was right on time, you know what I'm saying? Her looking out for me, the knowledge she knew, she'll give me, and I'd give her knowledge. I'm fresh out of my book, my Bible, you know what I'm saying? Lacing her up with a lot of stuff, and we just teamed up, man, like quickly, like within a month.
And I had just moved down here from Waco with my $3. And you know, I came from a bad place too. We both was in a place that we both was didn't know we was looking for something until we found each other. So from there, it's like the strength and the things that he did to me, it was like you can't find the words to say. It's all you can do is move off of the strength that he came and provided to me and my girls. You know, we was fragile when we met him. And he's like our superhero. Oh my, where to, how do I begin? The first date, we went to Don Carlos on 59. And then while we were sitting there eating, he had them come over and start singing. And they were singing.
Well,
I didn't know what they were saying.
They were singing.
I just said, oh, this is romantic. I don't know what they said, but they singing for me, so
I'm going to
take it. But yeah, we had a nice first date, and he was just a gentleman the whole time, and he just didn't even know he had won me over. He just won me over with being a gentleman and not just trying to push too much, just taking it slow. So
yeah, we had a great time. We sat there for a long time and ate. And you know, that was our first date, so we're still getting to know one another, and we talked for a long time, enjoyed the meal, and
didn't
want to
leave.
Didn't want to leave. It was, yeah, it was a nice day.
We are most alike with our drive and our determination and our love for family. We are family-oriented people. So our family is what I feel like we have similarities in.
Yeah, we have a drive. We got that drive.
We are like in so many ways. It's like, it's unbelievable when you can actually say you found your soulmate and actually met it.
The moment I knew she was the moment for me, it's kind of crazy because I had did a little time. And when I got out and ended up getting a job, and when I met her, you know, when I was incarcerated, I asked God to bless me with a woman, a good woman, when I got out. And I would pray for this all the time, you know, when I was incarcerated. So, you know, when I met her, and the chemistry was so strong, just from the moment, you know, we went on our first date, it's like I knew that she was for me. I asked for her, and God sent her to me. I know in my heart that he gave it to me. And I knew that she was the one when I first laid eyes on her, really. When I proposed to Sarah, I did it three times, actually. Because her sister didn't get to see witness, and she made me do it again. I'm going to say the proposal that, like, did it for me, that I think did it for her, is when we all went out. I went to this club called Altar one night. And me, Sarah, her sister, her brother, two of her cousins. And we was out, all of us was on the dance floor dancing. And her sister walked up to me and said, Junior, you proposed to Sarah.
I showed her my ring. I showed my sister my ring. And she's like, wait a minute. When this happened and I had told, she's like,
She was like, no, you have to do this again. I didn't get to see this. And I was like, man, you tripping. She was like, nah, I want to see this nigga. You want to marry my sister. You going to propose to me in my face. I'm like, Erica. She was like, nope, I want to see it. So I said, okay, I went and got me another shot of Patron. Got me another shot of Patron. And Twan was like our bodyguard, her brother. He was right behind us.
That's my baby, bro.
And we was dancing and stuff in the front, and Twan was just right behind us. And Erica was behind Twan's behind me, Erica behind Sarah. So the music kind of like went off and finna go to the next song. And I just got on one knee, and it's like the whole club stopped. I'm like, I'm in short little dude. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of people in here, and we right in the middle of the dance floor. But it's like a packed crowd. So I got on one knee, and the whole club just backed up, big old circle, and was watching. I'm like, man, I wasn't. I didn't know all this was going to happen. I'm trying to sneak and do it right quick. And I'm like, man, you know, I get on one knee and I grab her hand. I had got a ring. I grab her hand and ask her, will she marry me again? And put the ring back on her finger. Her sister was out doing all that. Oh. And so the whole club was like, man, that was so beautiful. And
clapping.
Started clapping for me. And I was like, yeah, it turned out pretty good. You know what I'm saying? But that was the proposal that I think, because it was unexpected, and then I had to do it in front of so many people. And she know me. I'm a people's person, but I'm kind of quiet. I don't really just, you know what I'm saying, like to do a lot of stuff in front of a lot of people and stuff like that, you know. But that was a great night.
That proposal meant a lot to me, like as of now, because my baby brother. He wasn't able to see us get married, but he was there for the proposal. So, like, I thought it, like, meant a lot to me because he was there to see that happen, you know, see that I was with a great dude.
Yeah.
On my big day, mostly I'm looking forward to is really seeing my husband's reaction to me coming down the aisle and not knowing what my dress looked like this time.
That's
what I'm just really looking forward to his reaction and to be able to experience with my family. Yeah.
We're going to Vegas.
It's gonna be a honeymoon / birthday.
Yeah, her birthday on the 13th. And our actual anniversary, I'm sorry, my mind just went blank. My actual anniversary is on the 31st. But we end up renewing our vows on the 3rd. And then June is her birthday month, so we figured go on our honeymoon on the 13th.
Celebrate 2-in-1.
But that same night that I proposed to you, we was towed up. When I say we was towed up, everybody was. Luckily, her sister didn't stay too far from us. But I remember, only thing I remember that night after the proposal was us driving. I don't know how we made it home. I remember lights being behind us.
God was on my side.
I got pulled out. Didn't get a ticket.
They say Harry gone to make it home.
My sister-in-law, I think she was following us. But it was crazy because I don't remember how we got home that night. I was towed up, man. They had put me under the gun, so I was taking those Patron shots. And man, I don't know
how
I got
home. That was for my birthday.
It was.
We went, yeah.
It was for your birthday.
Actually, that was a proposal for my birthday.
And
we had went out for my birthday.
Funny story, I don't know, it ain't probably a funny story, but. Baby, my message to you is for you to know that I'm gonna continue to love you with everything I got, with everything in me. I want to continue to make you happy, and I want us to just continue to love and respect one another like we've been doing to the end of our days. You mean everything to me. You're my everything. I love you, mama.
My message to my husband is I want him to know that he has made me the happiest woman in the world. He is my superhero, and I promise to love you until death do us part. I promise to honor you. I want you to know that we're grateful to have such a strong man in our life. Me and your girls and your grandsons, we love you so much, and we want you to keep being the man that God sent you to be.
And no other love will do. That's why I love.